Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Activities for People Living with Dementia. We're proud to offer this series with funding from the Area Agency on Aging and the United Way of Tarrant County. Some of our programs are recorded and some are made available for viewing through a YouTube channel for future use. I am Martha Brown, your host for today's activities, with my sidekick, the wet Mr. Woodstock. Today, it is our pleasure to present Emily Corbin. Emily's going to guide us in moving to heal chair yoga, also called Nia. Emily, I need you this morning. I'm glad you're here, and I'm going to turn it all over to you.
Thank you, Martha. Good morning.
Morning.
Yes, here we are on this Labor Day. So we will, we will get moving in our chairs and get ourselves warmed up for, I don't know, whatever activities are headed our way today, right? So we're going to sit on the edge of our seats and take our shoes off and sense our feet flat on the floor. So we want to sit with a comfortable space between our feet. And I'm going to sit back in my chair in a minute after we get our music started. Knees are coming straight out from the hips. And sense the shoulders stacked over the hips. And just sit for a moment, sensing your feet on the floor and sensing length in your spine. So I use this word a lot, sensing or sense, right? And for some of us, it is difficult to understand what exactly it is to sense. So I'll offer just a different perspective. And that is to notice or to be aware of. And so if you notice your spine, if you're aware of the feeling of your feet on the floor, and if you notice your breath as you take a breath in and out, what are some of the things that you notice about your physical experience? And you might give a numeric score to your lung volume as you inhale, smell the moment, exhale, release any tension. Let's do that one more time. And on a scale of 1 to 10, how would you measure your lung volume? And then noticing anywhere in your body that feels tight or dense or tense or bound. Noticing anything where you feel a room for improvement. And also noticing where you feel ease. So let's move our wrists, just the wrists. Feel free to close your eyes if that feels safe and comfortable so that you can sense, you can notice more of the information coming from the inside. And then let's move our ankles. So you might move your ankles by shifting the weight in your feet. You'll notice that that automatically causes all of the muscles and the tendons around the ankle joints to engage. Or you might lift the foot off the floor and actually rotate the joint. any of these ways of noticing how your body has shown up for you today is the right way. And then let's move at the hips, sending the chest around in a circle. And then let's come back to center, pause, sensing upright spine, lengthen your spine. And it's like there's a crown puppet string right up here at the top. And it's giving you all this length in the back of your neck. And then we'll go the other direction, circling, sensing this hinge at the hip. And all the muscles of the belly that engage as you move your spine, isolating the chest to one side and forward and around and back again. And then come back to neutral. Get totally still and upright. Relax your feet. Relax your shoulders. And now that you're nice and sleepy, we'll get you moving. So important for us to take a little inventory of the body before we get started. And oh, hello, my face was cut off, wasn't it?
Don't do that.
I know, only temporary. Wow, we got to start at the beginning of the song, right? That's helpful. Hello. Inhaling arms up. Exhaling arms down. We'll do it again. Up. They don't go quite as far. And down again. Now just shoulders, one and then the other, brush. Just soften your spine. Nice, it's subtle. One more each side. Nice, then we take our palms up again. Exhale, they go down, up. It's a smaller range of motion and down. Yeah, last one. Down again. And now the shoulders, the whole arm goes along. Slow motion. You can watch your hand float out. And now both arms lead with the elbow. Yeah. So the elbow lifts and drops. Yes. The elbow lifts and drops. Nice. We do it again. And drop. Side. One arm. One more time. And then feet come wider. Both arms a little faster now. Now you can let your whole body lean in to this arm movement. Stabilize through your feet. If your arms get tired, let them hang closer to the ground. but keep that movement in your spine. Nice. Now coming back close to the center, I'm going to take a step. And now the step's going to go a little faster. Shoulders brushing front. Nice. Right arm reaches and floats down. Left arm. Hi, Nancy, and it floats down. Right arm. Yeah, show me those creepy crawlers. Right arm. Let's let go of the walk. Just the left arm now. What about both palms up? Both palms down. Nice. Let's shake off the wrists a little bit. Shake off the shoulders and the face. Yeah. Here we are. So we're going to lift one foot and then the other. Lift. Now we'll step and reach the arms over to that same side, other side. Little pause right here. Step to the right. Step to the left. Either side is good. Other side, yeah. Can we add on a little tap and a little wave? Nice. Any side will do. Scooping, tapping, scooping, and tapping. Scoop. Now, what about reaching? So palms are changing to the other direction now. Reaching, yeah, and reaching. Now let's go back to the palms up. We're gonna tap to one side and other side. Whole foot, yeah. Now alternating, two, 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 and two. Nice. Two, last time for now. Let's take palms up, little sway side to side. You can swing bigger or smaller. Sense the strength in the sides of your body here. All right, so just one arm back to the center. Other side, and back to the center. Nice. Now, what if we did it single? Yeah, single. Nice. And then let's find that wave in your arm. I'm gonna add a squish walk with my heels. Pressing the heel down. With that exhale, reaching now to a corner. And then the back corner. What about way up high corners? Now, work on pumping the fist as you draw it in. You're pulling a heavy rope. Yeah. Now let's alternate corner. High corners and low corners. Yes. All right, feels like we need a sway. So relax your hands. Does it feel good to flutter and find creepy crawlers in your fingers? All right. What about an open palm? Can you sense an open palm without flexing the fingers? So it's just a spaciousness in your palm. Nice. Let's go back to the scoop. Scoop. And center, take your hands to your heart. Same thing. Scoop. Scoop. One arm. The other arm. Do it again. And stay here. So with your hands on your heart, sense your heartbeat. Sense or notice your breath in and out. And then let's reestablish the connection of our feet and the floor. So lifting one foot and then plugging it in. Same thing with your other foot. Let's plug it in. Everybody make that sound with me. Feel it? Feel the difference? All right. Plugging the foot in. So let's take a little, what do we call this? Duck walk. So at first we're going to go slow, lifting the ball of the foot, sensing that heel still plugged in. Lift, lift, lift. Yeah, and Martha, your shoulders know what to do. I want your arms to just be heavy. So rather than collapsing into one side, can it just be that one side is lifting so much it causes a contraction in the other side? Yeah. Nice. Now what if we take our hands and make a triangle? I see you guys right through the triangle. Yeah. Now keep keep that duck walk. It's going to go a little faster now. And all we're going to do is draw the triangle in front of our heart space. Nice. And push it out away towards the screen. Now bringing it in and around to the front. In, keep that duck walk. Nice. Anybody else's brain going, what? Yeah. Okay, do we rest our feet? I think we do. What about resting our wrists too?
That reminds me of my grandmother's treadle sewing machine.
Oh yeah. Wow, I haven't thought of one of those in a while. Let's pulse our heels. That's gonna help us send some healing vibrations up the front of the legs. Yeah, vibrate. All right, a little block. Pulling one elbow down to the side, gliding the other one across. So we're smooth as we travel through the middle. Now let's find not so much of that stop-start, but just a fluid movement, yeah? It's hard to see the block, right? When someone is moving in this fluid way, but it's still there, right? We started with this. Nice. So we're gonna play with those different sort of personalities of our movements here, yeah? So you guys can hear that da, da, da in the music, right? So let's play a little bit with that stop-start energy, right? We're gonna do that with a fist, all right? So remember, you've got those beans in your fist. We can't crush them. So your fist is loose enough, right, that you won't crush them, soft enough, or tight enough that you won't drop them. Yep. Okay. So let's punch down. Ha, ha. Ha, ha. Ha, ha. Now let's punch up. Ha. Huh. Let's bring it a little lower. So it's all your power is concentrated right here. Nice. Now let's let go of the punch. Find the contrast in this very fluid movement. All right. Now bring back your fist. So can we punch with a different personality? Nice. Now what about a playful punch? Not normally feeling playful when we punch, right? But let's give it a try. All right. And now let's come back to starting with the fist. The fingers hide behind the thumb. Let's do our fast stop start, yeah? You don't know, because you're agile, you're ready. Maybe it's on the beat, maybe not. All right, now what if we bring fluid So letting go of the and bringing a more fluid flick. Nice. And then we just fade away. All right. So now working with palms of the hands. And working with palms of the hands and the kinesphere, right? We've talked about the kinesphere. It's this space that we have to work with, right? All around the body. I use the idea of a bubble. It's more of an elliptical shape, truly. But imagine that there's this invisible space all around your body that's sort of holding you, right? So can you touch the edges of that with the palm of your hand, right? And it's not just above you and in front of you. It's definitely behind you. It's definitely below you. But wait, when we try to reach it down here, all of the ways that we support and stabilize the body, that changes, right? That has to adapt. Like if I was going to reach over and tie my shoe, wow, adapt my stability there. I might have to take this foot to the back a little bit. I don't know. How do you adapt to move in your kinesphere? What happens when you reach out to the front of the room? How do you support that movement? Right? Push your feet into the floor, engage your belly. Nice. And then let's bring a relaxed energy as we take our feet back underneath us. And again, exploring the kinesphere. So again, we just worked with this very agile kind of energy. And now we've brought the personality of childlike wonder, maybe. Definitely some characteristics of water and the way that the body moves in water. Nice. What about touching the kinesphere with one hand behind your back? Totally different experience. And then let's take that hand behind you and move with the other hand. Notice you feel more confident on one side, right? If you're right-handed, you probably feel more confident with your left hand behind your back. All good. What about up high? Where do you sense a stretch when you reach your arm way up and over? Let's do that on our other side, noticing where we feel opening, right? And notice if your foot comes off the ground, you don't get nearly the opening, right? Press the foot into the floor, sense more here. Good. So this music makes me want to roll my shoulders. Just kind of massage the shoulders here. As you do, allow your neck to move so the direction, right, is to roll your shoulders up into the back. Close your eyes and let those internal messages, right, the communications from inside, guide your neck movement. And then let's slow it way down. Bring yourself back to still. Take a pause with an inhale and exhale. And then with the fingers of one hand, we're going to brush down the outside of your arm. Now, just let your hand rest there. A little firm touch, like, hey, how's it going? Nice. Now relax your touch. And brush the outsides of your arm again. So the job of this arm that's receiving here is just to relax. And then we'll take both palms back to the thighs, get upright again. Our brushing fingers . You could try this with your eyes open, but with your eyes closed, you might be able to sense more. So a few brushes and then just the whole hand pausing, whole hand stops and rests there, firm touch, and then soften the touch. And brush again. Relax this arm. Yeah. Ugh. If you're holding your arm up, like here you go. Did anybody notice that? Okay. Whew. Let it relax down. Okay. And then a little friction between the hands. A little faster. Feel the warmth you're creating. And then slow down. And we'll let the palms rest up now. So lifting the right foot off the floor and finding a couple of rotations of the ankle. Let's bend and straighten the leg. I've got some breakfast cereal of the Rice Krispie variety in my knees this morning. Snap, crackle, and pop. Yes. Anybody else have that? Yeah. And then when you take your foot to the floor, plug it in. All right. And then the other foot lifts. Rotate your ankle. All around. Extend your leg. Say hello to whoever shows up there. And then plug it in. Feel that plug. All right. We'll inhale as we take palms up. And exhale as we take palms down. We'll do that one more time. And this time our arms stay extended out. Sense your wingspan Take your elbows just a little behind you, but below your shoulders. Yeah. And then exhale, bye, Lolly. Take your arms across your body. Big hug here. See if your fingers will grab onto something back there. And then with your exhale, just let the weight of your shoulders sink down. Your elbows drop just a bit. Relax your jaw. You can imagine smiling without moving the muscles of your face. It's this sort of internal smile. When you're ready, let your arms start to glide down. And then big inhale, sensing your wingspan again. And then sense your wingspan in all of the fingers. Exhaling, taking the opposite arm on top. Big hug. Exhale as you let your shoulders drop. Sensing lots of space. What's up, girl? Timmy's down by the river? He's in the creek? And letting the arms start to separate. Nice and slow. It's not your best side, dear. Let's bring our hands into the space of our heart. Lolly, come here. Come here. Come be in gratitude with us. Come here. Hi. That's a good spot. It's a good spot. So resting in gratitude for all the ways that we are in this world together, right? Gratitude for this body that moves us, this mind that moves this body, right? And this spirit that moves through all of it. Grateful for this day and the sunshine and for this community. Thanks, friends. Namaste. Let's clear the space. Lolly's ready to clear the space now. Inhaling, just lifting up whatever needs to be let go. Do it again. One more. And we step out.
Thank you, Miss Emily.
Thank
you. You're welcome. Thank you.
Oh. Your music is perfect for this morning.
Mm-hmm. Oh, good. Thank you.
Nancy, we're glad you made it in. She was having technical difficulties too.
Oh, really?
Of difficulty while you were playing. Did Emily break up for you, or was it only for us?
I didn't see a problem.
I didn't have a problem.
Okay, well then it was us.
There was a moment where I could see a delay, so I don't know.
It was several times, but you can't.
Oh, kept, really?
So that was good.
As long as you keep coming back.
That's right.
Always come. Yeah, the cat that came back, right?
Give Lolly a scratch for us.
Yetta, I was doing a geography quiz this weekend, and I kept thinking of you because you know, Americans don't know as much as we should, most of us, about Europe. Mm-hmm. And I just never occurred to me that Denmark has so much coastline.
Oh.
And I'm looking at it going, well, of course they have beaches, because I remember you telling us about beaches one day, about a beach in your hometown. And I was like, wow. That's right. And then I looked at it this weekend and went, yeah, it's pretty much all beach.
It's all water around us, except for where we are connected to Germany.
Yeah.
Amazing. And I'm grateful that it brought us all together.
Yeah, 400 yes. some islands. That's Denmark.
Wow. I'll never forget where Denmark is or how much of it is coastline now, and it's all thanks to you.
Thank you.
Yay. Well, Miss Emily, I have appreciated this. I want to see what's coming up. Let's see, remove a pen here. I want to see what's coming up for the rest of the day. I believe
it's all this.
It's Emily, 11:30 and 1:30. And drum roll, I am ready for tomorrow. Fitwits with Emily, mm-hmm. Emily. Hey. And we're swapping Tuesday for Thursday just for this week, just to see if everybody's awake. And we're going to do bingo on Thursday this week.
Right.
All right. So be ready.
Okay. All we right. will not be there tomorrow morning, but we will be for the 1:30.
Awesome. Okay.
We won't be good. There tomorrow.
You have a day out. That's correct.
Yes.
Glad you remind me, because sometimes I forget.
Yeah.
Yes. We have two more new friends that have just signed up with us. So when you drop in at 11:30 or 1:30, you will meet new people.
Good.
Yay. Thank you all for being here on this holiday, and let's celebrate the fact that we have Labor Day to celebrate.
Right.
All right. Yes.
All right.
Take care of yourself.
Bye.
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 Thanks, Emily.
Thank you. Bye. See you tomorrow. Yeah. Thank you. Bye.